Hello and welcome to Cheap Joe's Art Stuff. My name is Julie and I'm going to be imparting some knowledge to you today via a 2-minute art tip. So if you are the type that frames your own stuff, which is great because at Cheap Joe's we've got all the stuff. It's not hard. You should definitely try it out. But if you run into issues sometimes like I do where yes, think you're gonna finish at a standardized size and then sometimes you just don't, and the composition maybe gets a little, it goes in a different direction than you originally intended, then I suggest that you look at mixing some stuff up. Maybe consider doing an offset when you mat something. And what do I mean by that? That means that you're putting maybe an unconventional sized piece into maybe a standardized frame to save yourself a few bucks. But then you make up the difference with the mat. Here's how we do it. So, for instance, with this colored pencil piece, I ventured out of the lines a little bit and it got bigger than what I thought we were gonna go. So what happened was, I thought, oh, well, it would be cool if I put this in a larger format frame because it felt like the piece was kind of choked by a smaller frame. So what he did was went with this really, really big one. And then an offset generally means that you have the top and the two sides are even. And then the bottom is a totally different dimension so that the piece floats upwards in the frame space. And it kind of creates another compositional element and creates some extra visual interest when you frame it up. So it's a great way to save some money and not have to, you know, shell out a bunch of money for a custom frame. You can buy like a standardized size and just go with that. And it kind of looks pretty cool, I think. So try some offset framings. Super fun. Enjoy.